What is my life right now? What day even is it today? Oh my god. It's Friday. And oh my god! I just got a text from our friend Megan. You know Megan from Bucket Time.
Oh. Megan, you brought the bucket for me! Yeah,
this is the bucket, everybody.
She just texted me and said that she got tickets to see Hairspray, the national tour! I'm so excited. The show is next Saturday at 8 o'clock. Oh my god, I have so many things I have to do. I have to plan an outfit. There's so many things I have to do. Holy shit. Oh my god.
Malcolm, I'm seeing Hairspray. What do you think? Great, thank you so much. June, I'm gonna see Hairspray. What do you think? Oh.
She doesn't really care.
Oh, but you're so cute. Look at you go.
Hairspray has been one of my favorite shows of all time. It is my life's goal to play Penny at one point. Maybe Amber Von Tussle, I don't know. We'll just have to see what history says. I grew up with the movie with Nikki Blonsky and Michelle Pfeiffer, Christopher Walken, John Travolta, Zac Efron. Oh my God, that man. Elijah Kelly? The cast! But we're gonna get dinner beforehand too. I'm gonna try to maybe dress like on theme. That's what I like to do, no matter what show I go to. I try to dress on theme. So maybe I'll try to find something early 60s inspired. Maybe get some cute white boots. Oh my God, the possibilities! Right, so here's the plan. Mainly the vibe I wanna go for, obviously, it's set in 1961, I think. 61 or 62, one of those two. Early 60s is what we're going for. I have this pink checkered skirt that I haven't been able to wear anywhere because it's winter, it's cold. But I have that skirt that I really want to wear. It's not length appropriate for the time period, but we're not going to worry about that. Then I'm going to pair that with my white collared shirt because that's what, you know, people wore back then. I'm assuming. Then I'm going to curl my hair and poof it up because duh. If I could, I would do the pigtails, but we don't really have the real estate to do that. But I'm gonna poof up my hair a bit. I'm gonna add a headband, because I have a lot of those. Then from there, I wanna get a pair of white go-go boots, so they can go with the white and the pink, and it'll be a moment. And maybe I'll try to pair some earrings with that. I'm sure I have some somewhere. Oh my God. I have this pair of earrings that I got when Ariana Grande's Positions music video came out. They're exact replicas of the earrings that she wears in the album cover. They're green, they're flowers, be super cute with the pink. Ugh. Right, here's the problem I'm facing. So in an effort to make this outfit work, I was scrambling, trying to find an option where I could get these white go-go boots. I committed the mortal sin of ordering from Shein with express shipping. But here's the thing, before I submitted my payment, it said that if I use express shipping, it would be here before the show, like by this Wednesday or Thursday. After I submitted my payment, it said it wouldn't be here until the 17th. After the show. I'm just tracking this order like a moron, hoping that these shoes get in here in time and that they fit and that they work, which, I mean, granted, they are really cute, unlike other things you can get from Shein. But I'm hoping that the theater gods will answer my prayers and will allow the people who are shipping my package to get here as soon as possible. It's gonna work, it's gonna work, it's gonna work, it's gonna work. So it's now Wednesday, the show is on Saturday, and looking at the tracking of my shoes, there's no way in hell it's gonna make it even to the country in the next couple days. I'm gonna have to figure out a whole new plan. I do not give up though. I'm so stubborn, I don't give up. So my new plan now, I'm gonna ditch the pink and the green concept because I don't have any shoes that could go with it either way. I really wish I could just take my costume that I wore for Bye Bye Birdie 2.5 years ago? Jesus. I literally had like the full ensemble. I wish I didn't get rid of those shoes because, I mean, they were really worn out. I was dancing in them for 2 weeks straight and they were really dirty and really smelly. But you know what? We're gonna make it work. Also, if y'all are wondering why I'm only filming while I'm at work, I'm really busy this week. I forgot to mention this at the beginning of the video, but I'm hosting auditions. I'm a choreographer, so I've been doing that all week. I literally have callbacks tonight. So I literally had 2 days of auditions, Monday and Tuesday, and I had to teach the dance combination every single day. We had our high school auditionees and our little kid auditionees that had to come in. So I had to teach everybody the combination and evaluate and do all that stuff. But these are our final callbacks. And then tomorrow is like our decision day. And then Friday's our first read through. So I really don't have much time to figure this out. I wish I could like take the time to take a day and go thrifting and maybe find like a real authentic vintage piece, but I just do not have the time, guys. But I love what I do. I'm very happy that we're doing a production this year with my students who are delightful and wonderful, and I just love what I do. I wouldn't want it any other way. So it's fun, I like it.
It's Thursday. And I've come to a bit of a revelation in a way. I realized I've been spending all these days, and I'm not gonna lie, like all day today I was running around town calling all these different consignment stores, department stores, and retailers, just trying to figure out where I could find these shoes in such a short amount of time. And I think I finally realized, you know, I'm going to go see Hairspray, right? And the whole point of Hairspray is to, you know, dance to the beat of your own drum, you know? And it's meant to be this big celebration of individuality and diversity. And I think I've kind of been missing that. So I've finally come to the conclusion, although I will come out of this with getting a really cute pair of shoes by the time they get here, whenever they get here, I'm just gonna dress the way I want to dress. Cause why the hell not, right? There are a few pieces I've been wanting to wear lately that I haven't had the chance to wear, and I finally can. So I think I'm gonna do that. And now I can kind of have fun with it, not stress or worry about it. I can just kind of pick what I want, what I already have, and make something from that. Yeah. Yeah. Look at all of these options! My God, I can wear so many of these things if I want to. What? I've been going through my wardrobe the past couple hours, and I think my main winner is gonna be this guy here. It's this beautiful eggplant corduroy dress that I think I'm gonna layer with like a black mock neck under here. And then, oh, wear those boots I had earlier. These boots, which are super comfortable and so stinking cute. And I think I'll just curl my hair like I usually do, and then we'll have some fun with makeup, because why not?
I've been cleansed of my sins.
Your girl washed her hair so it's nice and fluffy and ready to curl for tomorrow.
I'm so excited. You all will get to meet Megan tomorrow. We're gonna meet for dinner.
It's gonna be so fun. I can't wait. I hope that tomorrow's workday goes swiftly as possible so I can just skip right to the good stuff for tomorrow.
Good morning, friends.
Saturday! Yes, for the past 24 hours, I have been looping Green Green Dress from Tick Tick Boom with Andrew Garfield. Why aren't you? But besides that, I've got to go get ready for work, be there for a few hours, and then I get to rush home and put my outfit on and get ready. And here's the kitty to say good morning. Hi, baby.
You come here.
Hi, baby. Your girl has made it. I got super busy and then my coworker finally came in, so I was like, bye. I'm headed to my car and I'm zooming home so I can get ready and do all the fun stuff.
I then proceeded to change my outfit for the third flipping time because I'm an indecisive buffoon. I shall now reveal the outfit through the magic of spending too much time on TikTok.
Deep dark velvet hugs your silhouette. Black silk stockings, you're my Juliet. Soft long hair, baby, beautiful eyes. Cool me down before I jump into your thighs. The green, green dress, 20 buttons and a strap. The green, green dress, what a pleasure to unwrap.
Liv, what do you think of my outfit?
I like it.
What do you like about it?
Matches your personality.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi!
Hello, baby.
Hello. We're in the car. Are we playing in Kanto?
Yes, I am.
Yes! This is Megan, everybody!
How excited are you right now?
I'm
so excited.
But I'm also starving, so we're gonna get food beforehand.
So hungry.
We're gonna get the food and listen to Encanto. Hell yeah!
Have you seen it?
Oh, like 3 times.
Yeah. I've seen it.
We've made it, Megan.
We've made it.
Food. I forgot the fact that we live in the city and it's a Saturday, but
we talk about this fit for a second. Look at her.
Grecian goddess.
Megan's found her best friend.
We made it inside. It's really happening, everybody. We're here, we're thriving, we're living. Yeah. You can't stop the beat. I don't even know where we're sitting. Megan, you're taking me somewhere and I don't know where.
We heard a beep.
I think it's time.
We heard a beep.
I heard a beep.
Beep.
I know all my students came here 2 days ago.
It is officially half hour until curtain.
Half hour till show.
How do we feel, Megan?
Thank you, half hour.
So, Megan, you have not told us where we are sitting.
Yep. I'm surprised.
Why?
Because you're gonna lose your whole mind, I think. I think you're really gonna like it.
I'm excited. Yeah. I just can't wait to see this with you. Like, I'm like legit. You texted me and I was like, no way am I cool enough to see this with Megan. Doors are opening. Things are happening. Oh my god. Oh snap. Thank you. In the where now? Where are we? Why are we going so far, Megan? Megan, why are we going so far? What? You were joking. You're messing with me right now. We're not sitting this close. Megan! Megan!
25 and 26.
What? We're so close to the stage. I'd like to take this moment to thank Megan's aunt for these tickets.
Shout out Aunt Debbie.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great.
I'm very excited. These are very good seats.
You think? Hang on.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You've got to be kidding me.
We're in row F.
Yeah.
Row F. For fuck's sake, these seats are closed. Lucas, I know you're watching this, but just know, no matter what production does Hairspray, I am always going to fall in love with whoever plays Lake Larkin. So just know that.
By default, that's how it legally works by law.
When you're friends with a famous person, that's our girl.
Okay, the show's gonna start in like literally 2 minutes. And
I'm so excited.
I will update you guys probably at intermission, so I'll see you guys then.
I'm back. It's intermission. Megan had to go to the bathroom because, you know, what we ladies have to do around here. First of all, I doubt anyone in the company will be seeing this vlog because, you know, they're busy with life. But the understudy for Seaweed is ridiculous. I'm looking for the name here. Jamonte, I believe that is how you pronounce your name. You're doing a wonderful job. You are killing it. Understudies and swings are keeping theater alive right now. And you all are wonderful and amazing. And I'm so happy that there are positions available where that is something that can be done to keep theater alive. And oh my God, it's amazing. Okay, I'm trying not to include audience members behind me because I try to respect their privacy, but I'm looking through this playbill and I was watching the show and I swear to God, I've seen Hairspray live like 500,000 times. I have it on DVD and I swear one of the chorus members was on Hairspray live and I'm looking through the playbill and it's her. I knew it and she's playing the same role. Helene, however you say your name. I'm so sorry if I'm mispronouncing it. You were doing a wonderful job and I recognize you from the show and you killed it then and you're killing it now. You're wonderful.
Can we also talk about the fact that for this performance, I don't know if it's usual for all performances, but they added a male Dynamite, which is so wonderful and amazing. And just, I guarantee you there are kids who are seeing this show and are now saying, I can do that. That's insane. I'm gonna go cry now. Thank you. Hi, it's Editing Haley here. I totally forgot to mention this while I was in the theater, but I just had to point out this particular moment that made me laugh my ass off. So it was during I Can Hear the Bells, you know, this big wedding fantasy that Tracy's having. And in the background, I just see Velma Von Tussel just shredding the organ, like putting her heart and soul into it. Like she's on America's Got Talent. And it was the single greatest thing I'd ever seen in my entire life. Thank you. Goodbye.
The show is marvelous. You all are wonderful. And I'm going to look at this playbill some more and maybe see if I can find some interesting facts about some of them so I can geek out more.
Megan, what are your TFEs, your thoughts, feelings, emotions?
Oh my god, I loved it! Oh, so pretty. Oh my god.
I am a wreck. I am shambled. I am shook to my core.
Okay. The show is spectacular. I adore it. I still do. I always have. I always will. Oh man. I love dance. That I love theater, and the fact that those two things can be combined to the same piece of art is really, really special to me. I'm pretty sure none of the cast members could see, but I was attempting to do the finale choreography because I've seen the live version so many times. I know the choreo. I was just so happy and I was going for it. It relit the spark that reminds me why I want to do this. I'm sure dozens of kids, hundreds, thousands, millions of kids out there feel the exact same way. I'm just really grateful that I'm one of the few people that get to experience it the way that I did.
It's pretty late. I have work in the morning, so I unfortunately have to take this makeup off, but I feel really pretty with it. I tried to do like a lavender smoky eye. It's most definitely worn out by now, but I wanted it to match the purple in my dress, so I figured it'd be fitting. To the company of Hairspray on Tour, I adore you. Thank you so much for coming to Grand Rapids to give us a wonderful piece of live theater. Please, please come back anytime you like. And if, worse comes to worse, if things happen and understudies and swings are unavailable and you need someone who knows the choreo, let me know. I'll send my headshot and resume. I'll send it your way. To Megan, I adore you. Thank you so much for the ticket and for taking me. I love you so much. I hope I wasn't too embarrassing next to you to be your future show buddy for other productions. It's really weird. I've seen a few professional shows in my life, and when I was younger especially, and after I would leave, I would get this feeling of there's no way I could do that. These people are so ridiculously talented, that can't be me. And I saw this now, having been part of productions in my area that are very renowned nationally, and I'm very grateful for that. And I came to see this show and I felt this weird spark of, I can do that. That never happens. I have such a damaged self-esteem. But lately, I'm putting my foot down and I want to do this. I just need to start. Okay, I'm going to bed. And hopefully I'll see you guys soon.